Hey guys, welcome at my YouTube channel. I'm from Germany, but I try to support you English speaking people too about my experiences printing the Piper Cup from 3D lab prints with lightweight PLA from Isan. It's no how-to, it's much more how I did and how maybe not to do, but maybe you learn from one or more of my failures, of my fails. So let's go on. So as you see, I used the Cura slicer, and my first attempt was a temperature of about 270 degrees Celsius, see in the red ring, and at the left you can see I scaled the little piper up about 10%. I went to the checkbox left and wrote 110, so 10% more than the original size. I think it would be more nice and flying more stable. Here you see this yellow surface. It's the bottom thickness in the checkbox at the right upside. And this was my first fail, because for examining these different fuselage sections, there shouldn't be a bottom surface. Okay, you're gonna do it better. Follow my video and you will see how to print it correct. And here is the case for a lot of issues with the blobs. You're gonna see later. It was in front of my eyes, but I didn't saw it. I had a good support from the Facebook group. It's in German, 3D Druck für alle, 3D printing for all. Most of these guys are speaking English, so don't be shy to join this group. They are very helpful. For a short moment, you saw the YouTube channel of Troy McMillian. His videos are very helpful too, so I won't remind you. Okay, now we go on the right side, this outliner, and I'm doing some stupid things, not knowing exactly what I'm doing here. Here I'm doing the fail with the bottom layer. As you see, bottom thickness 0.4 millimeter. This would be about one line and two top layers. No, second. 0.4, that means one bottom layer. Excuse me, one bottom layer, 0.4 millimeters with a nozzle width of 0.4 millimeters. What the video don't shows, I started printing with 270 degrees in case of the in case of the writing on the Isan PLA. You see 270 degrees. The video, the screenshot video didn't show. What's coming out here is a rest from the former PLA. This was a standard PLA, blue PLA. But however, now we are printing with the Isan lightweight PLA. It's a kind of foaming reaction in the nozzle, which makes this material lighter. Pretty much lighter. I show you in a later video weight comparison between both. No, I did in the video before, sorry. I did in the video before and I showed it weights more than half less than the blue standard PLA. So more than the half weight less. Okay. But there is one issue of this material. This is the bottom line of the model. You see, this is oval circuits. These are for the control lines and some strengthening structures. And once again, 270 degrees. And the guys in the Facebook group said, no, never too hard. Okay, but as you see, Isan recommends from 190 degrees to 270 degrees. And here you see the result, the not satisfying result. Don't do this. During later tests, I found the best temperature for this lightweight PLA is 241 degrees. But maybe you need some test prints. Okay, here, that's my newest toy. It's a temperature camera. How do you say? Infrared camera? I'm not sure. And this didn't bring me further in my issues. But however, for the first moment, I've been happy just to print anything looking in some way like this fiber fuselage. And all this spider web kind of lines, of strings, are resulting in some in some miss settings I did, and the video gonna help you to find the best settings. This should be at the end of this video series the result for you, acceptable settings in Cura 5.5. Okay, newest version, I think 5.2, to print your Piper. And there will be, okay, here is the big one, my big one, flying model Piper PA18, wingspan of 3.20 meters. And the original towed my glider years ago, when I was an active glider pilot. Okay, but here we go again. Temperature 245, bottom layer 0. Now you can check by preview, and as you see, no bottom thickness, no bottom surface. We don't need it. Later we're gonna need it for the rudder levers, but step by step I show you when printing the control surfaces. This model is made very, very nice, and thanks to 3D Lab, it's free. Don't know why. Maybe to encourage you to start with printing and then buying other models. That's a good business plan. And here, once again, have a look. The issue is in front of my eyes, and let's see if maybe can someone in the comments write what he supposed, what's the issue is. This is the SSD card, the one delivered by Creality with my printer. Besides, in the show notes, I gonna link some of the products I use. Maybe interesting for you. And here, once again, I do some stupid things. I do it in time, no? Time lapse. Okay, 14 times faster than in reality, however. Okay, printing temperature 242, bottom layer 0, top layer 0. And here we go once again. This somehow like tube structures upside are for the control lines. That's maybe not the way you should do, because the mechanic maybe be damaged. As you see, my printer is pretty new, about 3 months, but you see some debris, and sometimes I'm gonna make a video about how to maintain the printer. This is not acceptable. The debris of the rolls, of the rollers and all that stuff. Maybe you use, like me meanwhile, sprays, like to clean the keyboards of the computer. Okay, so here we go. Second part of fuselage. Nice. In front still the part with the bottom surface, and it don't looks pretty nice. This is the tail section, beginning tail section with elevator root, elevator, and for the rudder, linkage for the rudder. But I don't use it. There are the blobs beginning, and believe me, in one or two of my next videos, I gonna show you the case for these blobs and how to solve. Once again, here's the case, the root case for the blobs. You're never gonna believe it. I wanted to believe it too, but in the next video I show you. Okay, here we start to print now the upper surface of the rudder. Once again, on the left side, scale it up, 110%. And right up you see I created meanwhile an LDPLA Piper file at the right upside, and if you open the check box, you have the possibility to save your settings, to change your settings, give it a new name, or save it like it is. And it's very comfortable, as you see here. When you sliced it, after your slicing, it's be saved to the transportable SSD card. I recommend you, for starting any printing, doing this simulation with the right lever, with the right handle, the black handle, you can change the layer height, and with the handle on the bottom you can simulate the travel of the printer. At this moment I've been very optimistic. I thought this is gonna be a nice print, but then I walked around my printer to the other side, and I can't believe. But once again, 3D Druck für alle, those guys, I shared a video on this Facebook site, and they are very experienced, and they said to me, It's too slow. The set retract is too slow. You must imagine, I show it here for you. If you cut off the heating of the nozzle, this lightweight PLA is going on foaming. Look at that. There's still foamed string coming out, and in the next video I will show you how to fix this issue with a set travel. And bye bye.